Should I throw this?
Hell no, don't throw it. It may blow up.
In Sevier County, Tennessee, after getting kicked off their still site at the peak of their season, Mike and Jerry rebuild in a new location to get back in business.
This is mine and Jerry's first run at the brand new still site. We're real excited. Yeah, we got a mixture of oats and barley here. Got it worked off real good. We got to get this stuff pumped over. Go ahead and break this new site in. There she goes. You know, we can mash in anything we want to, but when it comes to this column still, you're not gonna have much flavor at all, because this thing is designed to make good, clean, neutral spirit to mix with anything you want to mix with it. You know, me and Jerry, we've done pretty well this year selling our regular clear alcohol. People like it. Ready to fire up?
No, you're ready.
All right.
I'm going for the first time at the new site, baby.
I believe this calls for a good stiff drink.
We'll have one for sure.
No, I got something in the damn truck we can drink.
Oh, do you?
Hell yeah, some good stuff, too.
Let's get started.
You know, before the pandemic come around and all this crap hit the fan, I had an old-timer get up with me. He wanted to trade out. He had this bottle. He homemade this stuff. And so I traded him a couple of good clean jars of liquor for this. You talking about something good, something that I really like.
Yeah. What you got there?
It's Amaretto.
Looks like a doggone dark whiskey.
It's good, man, I'm telling you.
That is good. It's got a lot of unique flavors to it.
I know it's got almonds, peach pits and stuff in it.
Kind of like a good liqueur.
Like a liqueur, that's exactly right. The flavor's so good that I would like to put something like that out there, man, for people, you know? Don't have to taste identical to this, but I want it to be as good. You see what I'm saying?
Oh, yeah.
You know, during this pandemic, we've done pretty good for selling this good clean alcohol that we're running off. Mighty damn, it's good, man. But we're not all about just trying to make money. We're sitting in a position now that we can get a little something out there that's different, tastes good, and people can enjoy. The real base of this stuff is the almonds. I wonder if we can make something near damn close to that good a damn taste, say maybe with pecans. You know, where I come from in Mississippi, we made out of pecans all the time.
We're in the mountains of Tennessee. We're gonna find pecans at.
Pecan trees grow here too, just like down walnut trees do.
Get this run knocked out, we'll go get us a bucket full.
That's exactly right. We gotta get the liquor run off first, don't we?
Yeah, she won't be long now.
There she flies.
How's it smell?
It smells good, it smells hot. Let's have us a horn of this good stuff over here.
Oh!
This Amaretto is very complex. I can taste cherry in it. You taste the almond nuttiness, the bitterness in it. It almost tastes like it's got a roasted coffee bean in it somewhere.
Damn, that's fine. That'll make your sticker peck out right there.
You know, we are moonshiners, and we like to think outside the box and come up with something creative, you know. You out of the heads?
Oh, it's good and clean now.
Yeah, chunk. We're running a clean, neutral spirit from oats and barley today. It virtually has no taste whatsoever. So we're gonna be able to infuse flavors through this alcohol to make it taste like we want it. I think I like it too damn good.
Mm-hmm.
I want you to sit down there a little bit.
Bath, you. You know, there's not a whole damn lot of pecan trees in Tennessee, but I do know where there's a small grove down by the river. I tell you what, this is the right time of the year for them. So you don't want to take these green ones right here. They're still encased in their hull. When they turn brown, they'll open up and actually drop the nut out of the hull, like these right here. Well, the reason I know a good bit about pecans is that I grew up in Mississippi, and we spent a lot of our time gathering up down pecans for pies. That was a big staple down there, you know?
Yeah.
Well, still is to this day.
Nuts have been used to flavor alcohol for centuries. Medieval monks made the first alcoholic liqueurs, secretly blending herbs, nuts, seeds, and even tree bark to make their potent concoctions. Amaretto was born in Italy, made from the bitter kernels of almonds, apricots, and peaches. When broken down, the bitter component in these kernels produces both toxic cyanide, most of which is eliminated during distillation, and benzaldehyde, the organic compound that gives Amaretto its nutty flavor.
Watch this right here. Look at the pecans falling.
Right my bucket.
Caught one, didn't you? Tell you what, right now I'm feeling very lucky. Look at them, man. They're just all over the damn place. Because you know, pecan trees, every single year they don't bear. You'll have a real good year, then you'll have a year where they only have a handful of nuts on them.
We just gotta figure out how we can pull this flavor off.
Exactly. These little jokers here is gonna be hard to get in, but they got a flavor like none other, though. Anything harder to get in always seems to be better.
Those are really good.
Jerry, I just hope we can make it good and some alcohol. You know, with everything going on today, anytime we can get something for free, it's a win-win for us. We don't have to go out, spend our hard-earned money, and we can still make top-shelf premium liquor for half the damn price.
What are you doing sitting down eating the damn pecans for?
Well, they're pretty damn good.
He's just like a damn squirrel. All the time wanting to gnaw on some nuts some damn where. From the ground to hand to the jar, baby.
If you went to the grocery store and bought 10 gallons of pecans, even unshelled, this would be hundreds of dollars worth of pecans, and we got them for free.
So what do you got on your mind as far as extracting flavors?
Well, I don't know quite yet.
I've never made alcohol flavored with any kind of nuts.
Me personally, all I've ever done was gather them, busted them, and eat. My grandma and them wanted done all the candies and pies. We got to come up with how we're gonna do this. I mean, you see the oil? I mean, that just about dripped off my finger now. When you smell that oil, that's where you get all your flavor out of.
Well, we just need to get the flavor to it. I'm thinking we make like an extract more. That way it won't take a whole lot.
Get us a good flavor profile going on.
I tell you what, if we can get all these busted and get all the oils and stuff extracted out of these pecans, it's gonna pack a powerful punch.
There's plenty of flavor in that nut.
Yeah, that's what she said. Boy, yeah, looky, looky here. They're nice and caramelized, Jerry.
We've gotta do something creative here to try to get these oils out of these pecans.
Get our welding together.
Yeah.
Jerry come up with the idea to say, well, let's press the oil out of them to extract all that oil and we can get the most amount as we possibly can.
Gonna do it?
I believe so, Bubba.
You know, I have a hydraulic press.
Woo-wee. Just had to homemade a pressing jig. And if we can just get some earls out of them pecans, we'll be in high damn cotton, won't we?
Yeah.
Load that bad boy up, Jerry. Here we go.
Look in there, look in
there. All right, baby.
We got oil.
That's a tail oil, won't it?
We got it running out the back.
Woo-hoo! We got oils coming out. Holy damn. Oh, taste that. Damn almighty, that is fine, boy. Oh my God, dude. That is phenomenal.
I can about drink that by itself. It's got kind of a smoky, burnt, nutty flavor to it.
I don't feel like that we're gonna have to add a whole lot per jar of alcohol to get this flavor because this oil is, I mean, super concentrated.
Damn, that is a...
That's a pecan pancake right there.
It's almost dry. Mm-hmm. Feel of it.
It will.
Yeah. Here we go, tails off. I'd say that's about enough for a taste, ain't it?
Gives room to shake.
Ain't no need in wasting something if it ain't gonna turn out.
Pour it from drops anyway.
We gotta be careful with this oil because we don't wanna mix too much and just overpower it. It's gotta be there, but yet it's gotta be a drink of liquor you wanna take a good shot of and have that flavor on the back note. It tastes like pecan. It's got the smoke flavor in it.
Really damn good. I like, try it.
It's crazy, ain't it?
It's in there, ain't it?
What's there?
In there like a hair in a biscuit.
I love it. I think it's great. It's even got that little bit of a charry taste to it as well.
I never thought we'd ever accomplish it.
Right there it is.
But I'm tickled to death with it. I mean, I like it. I'm satisfied with it.
You know what the damn main goal is here today? Me and Jerry's pulled this off. We figured out how to put pecan flavor into alcohol and we nailed it down.
So make sure we get all that oil off the bottom there.
Damn, you spilling our damn oil, Jerry.
A damn jar of slicker, son.
Oh, I say it is. It's got oil on it.
It's costly, huh?
Yeah. Damn, you clumsy today, ain't you?
There you are.